Then there's the, all the ignorant people are kind of going nuts over the SpaceX rocket blowing up. You see Thunderfoot's video on the test launch. I saw 30 seconds and that was all I needed to see. If he doesn't understand why they were applauding, he doesn't understand anything about it. And I think pretty much my response to the Young Turks applies to Thunderfoot. Because the point of the test, and again, Thunderfoot just does not look at these things, which, considering it was explained in the live stream before the launch, makes it pretty inexcusable. The real test was clearing the launch pad, because they wanted to see what kind of damage it would do to the launch pad, and they wanted to make sure the first stage could be stable, you know, coming off the launch pad. And as one of those engineers said, okay, it's cleared the launch pad, everything now is icing on the cake. And even, like, I've seen, you know, the news media is all like, oh, what's Musk going to do now? He lost this rocket. How far back is that going to set him? None, because if you'd actually watched the live stream or did the slightest bit of research, you know that in this test, that rocket was always going to be discarded no matter what. But what happened with the Starship rocket was it was supposed to separate the first stage, and it didn't, so it went boom. But the planned idea was to ditch the first stage in the Gulf of Mexico, because they're in Texas on the coast of the Gulf of Mexico, shooting it out over the Gulf, so it wouldn't be over any populated areas, and it was away from all air traffic and everything. They got the clearances from all that. And they keep talking about, like, it was going to make a hard landing. Hard landing basically sounds like a crashing into the ocean is basically what it was. But it was going to go down in the Gulf of Mexico. And then the rocket itself, the Starship rocket, would have made not quite a full Earth orbit and come down some number of miles off the coast of Hawaii. And again, you know, they talked about a hard landing. And they said they were not going to bother to recover it. So, I mean, this was always going to be the one and only thing they did with this rocket. So. But people like Thunderfoot and the Young Turks, they don't even look into that. They didn't even watch the friggin' live stream. The SpaceX disaster was a mere setback on the road to space settlement. It wasn't even a setback. The test was successful.
Yeah.
They did everything they set out to do with that test.
Yeah.
And a little more besides. Yeah, one of the commenters on my Young Turk videos was like, yeah, they're going to look at a Toyota doing a crash test and go, oh no, look at how bad that Toyota got mangled up in that test. That's basically what they're saying.
Yeah, fun fact, you know, we see images of car wreckages and all that, and we're like, wow, that's terrible. Nobody must have survived the accident. Then you find out that everyone escaped with minor injuries. It's like, but how? The car's completely totaled. Guess what, people? They're supposed to crumble up like that in an accident.
Yeah, it's actually worse to be in one of those old cars from the 50s that was basically a chunk of metal that wouldn't do that, because that means all the energy of the impact gets transferred to you.
Yeah, I mean, if I recall correctly, a pretty good example is look at the car that killed James Dean. I saw pictures of the car after the accident. The car's pretty well good. It's got some dents and dings, but it's pretty intact. But Dean didn't survive.
And then you have that Tesla where the guy tried to do a murder-suicide of himself, his wife, and his two kids, and drove it off, like, I think a 300-foot cliff, and they needed to go to the hospital for treatment, but they all survived. And I mean, you look at the picture, and the Tesla is basically matchsticks.
Yeah. But like we just said, you know, they're supposed to do that. That means the car is absorbing all the energy.
Yeah.
Because if it's not absorbing the energy, that energy has to go somewhere, and well, you're there.
Yep. If it's not going to crumple the car, it's going to crumple you. So take your pick. Oh, God, here's the headline. SpaceX just destroyed an entire town. Yeah, there's all sorts of hysterical headlines about this.
Oh, God. Wait, what outlet is it from?
Giant Freaking Robot.
Oh, God.
According to the New York Times, the SpaceX Starship launch caused an unknown amount of unforeseen environmental damage to the surrounding area. Port Isabel themselves said that they couldn't detect any problems. But it's an unknown amount. That's one of those things they think when they're just trying to make it sound bad. Yeah, the launch was not successful, and the Starship rocket exploded before making it into orbit. I don't know, are they just fundamentally dishonest, or...